On October 6th, they changed to night attacks. Maybe that way they could avoid those deadly Spitfires and hurricanes. Maybe that way they could crush the stubborn British spirit. Never mind control of the air. Never mind phase one, phase two, phase three. Now to concentrate on bombing the people themselves into submission and make them cry for mercy. Wasn't much help at night. This was just German bombs against British guts.
Harvey?
Hello, Jack.
Sound happy enough down there tonight, don't they?
Yes, they're all right.
The great docks of London were left roaring infernos. Homes were destroyed by incendiaries. Business blocks were aflame.
And still the people of London took it. Night after night they bored underground. And morning after morning they dug themselves out of the wreckage.
Good morning, Mrs. Fox.
Good morning, Mr. John. See you tonight.
What is it?
Come on, Bessie. Would you like to sit down? Thanks.
Boy, Mr. Arnn, sleep well?
Fine, thanks. Wasn't it a quiet night?
What about the one that came down about 2?
No, I didn't hear it. Did you?
No.
Oh, we're getting used to them around here.
For a bit?
Of course not. It'd take more than this to get me out of my home. Now go on, you've got to get to work.
The Battle of London was the battle of the people of the city. In spite of bombs and fire and death, they got to their desks and workbenches to spend another 10 or 12 hours working, working, working. The British spirit was stronger than ever. The RAF was flying higher than ever. Not only higher, but farther.
SIO, operation for tonight.
GP1562, EP781, 10 aircraft.
You'll find, I think, a decent photograph of the submarine yards there.
Mm-hmm. There's a very good one taken the other night, Monty.
Who's that?
It's further along.
That's it. Those are the submarine yards.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, chaps, this is your target for tonight. It's the submarine and shipbuilding yards at Bremen. It's a vitally important target, and it's got to be hit hard.
In the midst of this life and death struggle, the British found strength not only to defend, but to counterattack with what few bombers they could get together.
wrong, sir.
Hello, rear gunner. Can you hear me?
I'm okay, skipper.
Hello, operator. Everything okay?
Well, it seems to be all here, sir.
Stand by, I'm going in a glide.
Here was the RAF giving it back. Hitler cried, "Night gangsters, for this crime I will exact a thousandfold revenge." All the available German night bombers were put into the air.
Thousandfold revenge was Coventry. On the night of November 14th, £1 million of bombs were dropped on the city. Coventry was smashed as flat as Warsaw and Rotterdam. Coventry dug their loved ones out of the blasted ruin, saw them to their last resting place in a common grave.
Hitler could kill them, but damned if he could lick them. They went back to their lathes and machines, for they knew the machine bench was as deadly a weapon as the rifle. And in their hearts was a grim determination that this enemy must be destroyed. That the day was coming when they would strike back. And how they would strike back.